welcome back to my Men's Fall and Winter Essentials series. So today I want to go over some of my favorite sweaters during this time of year, which are crew necks, cardigans, and shawl collar cardigans. So these are all really great because not only do they keep you warm, but they also allow you to create a bunch of new looks depending on how you layer them with the other items you own. But before I go any further, I want to make sure you've watched my V-neck sweater video because one, you should already own a bunch of V-neck sweaters because they look great on every body type and you can wear them year round. And two, that way you know the do's and don'ts with sweaters and how they should fit depending on your body type, because I'm gonna be talking about crew necks and cardigans with the assumption that you already know all of these guidelines. So if you haven't already watched that one, stop watching this video, go to the description, I've linked my V-neck sweater video and check it out. Oh, and don't mind the blonde hair in that video. It was just a phase, I promise.
2 hours later.
So now that you and I are on the same page in regard to the basic tenets of sweaters, and hopefully your closet is now brimming with V-neck sweaters, let's talk about their brother from another mother, the crew neck. So I really like crew necks because they can be worn over a t-shirt, unlike with V-neck sweaters, and they look really great with casual outfits, or you can take a more formal outfit, like a suited look, and dress it down even further. They also just provide a really nice warm layer to your outfit as well. The two things you want to remember to do when it comes to your crew neck sweaters is to make sure you nail down that fit and you know how to wear them based on your body type. For any body type, you want to make sure your crew neck fits like a glove. So what I mean by that is you shouldn't be able to pinch more than 1 inch of fabric on your tricep, and you shouldn't be able to pinch more than 2 inches of fabric on one side of your stomach. As for the length, make sure your sleeves generally end around the bend of your wrist, and the length of your sweater should hit just past your belt buckle. You don't want it any longer or shorter than that. It just drives me absolutely nuts when I see a guy wearing a sweater that is just bunching with a ton of fabric over here and a ton of fabric in the sleeves. You don't want that. Please don't be that guy. If you're a broader guy, you only want to wear your crew neck as a layering piece. So underneath a jacket, sport coat, or a suit, you don't want to actually wear it on its own because it'll actually create this huge swath of fabric that will only spotlight your girth. And trust me, I'm not talking about below the belt. Now let's move on to cardigans, specifically regular and shawl collar styles. Now I'm like having girth in my head and spotlight shawl collar styles. As to how your cardigans should fit, the same crew neck rules apply. So just like your crew necks, cardigans look great with most shirts. I would just avoid V-neck t-shirts unless it's a really shallow V, because the double V that it creates, it just looks very strange. Also, I would not recommend wearing a polo shirt with a cardigan because the collar of a polo is just too flimsy and it won't look right or lay nicely when worn with a cardigan. Regular cardigans can be worn on their own, or they can be worn underneath everything, including a suit. While shawl collar cardigans should really only be worn on their own because they're generally made out of a thicker wool or cotton. If you're a larger guy, a regular cardigan should only be worn buttoned all the way up, except the last button, you want it to actually be undone. So when you're sitting down, it doesn't bunch up. And it should only be worn as a layering piece underneath something. If you wear a regular cardigan on its own, then it's actually gonna make you look super wide because again, it creates a huge swath of fabric, which is what you wanna avoid. If you have a slim to average build, then you can wear a regular cardigan either on its own or as a layering piece, but almost always have it buttoned all the way up. Just make sure that last button at the bottom isn't fastened. That way you won't have all of this bunching when you sit down. I'm not a big fan of having cardigans be completely unbuttoned because they just start to lose their structure and they start to begin to look floppy and really messy looking. For shawl collar cardigans, if you are a broader guy, then you should absolutely wear them on their own and completely unbuttoned. When you have it unbuttoned, then it actually breaks up your width nicely and it hides any kind of problems areas that you might have in your stomach or your upper body. If you're any other body type, then you can wear your shawl collar cardigan buttoned or unbuttoned. But if you do decide to fasten it all up, make sure to leave the bottom button undone. That way you don't have any bunching. As for colors, I already mentioned them in the intro video for my men's fall and winter essential series. It's a mouthful, sorry. So definitely check out that video where I go over all the colors that will work great for your skin tone. And lastly, as far as materials, I really like wool and cashmere, although cashmere is technically wool, but I still consider these two different types of materials. Cashmere is a little softer and it's a little bit more expensive. And if you're a guy that runs a little bit warmer, then I recommend going with a cotton blend because it's a little bit more breathable for you. So let me show you how to style some of these sweaters. So first, I styled my model in this crew neck sweater that's worn over a t-shirt. I throw on a coat and some wool trousers and wingtips. Next, he's wearing a coat, gray cardigan, dress shirt, and tie with wool pants and some brown monk straps. And lastly, I styled him in this navy shawl collar cardigan with an Oxford button-down, some dark wash jeans, and chukka boots. So those are my favorite sweaters during this time of year. Leave me a comment below and let me know which of these three do you like best. Check out my website for an in-depth article that includes all of my favorite sweaters out there that fit every price point. Subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. All right, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.